Oh, thanks, Harry. I'm here with, stand here with none other than Indiana Jones Jr. himself. And this exclusive interview, we will be discussing what he has done since his last monumental discovery just a few years ago. Now, Mr. Jones.
You can call me Indy.
All right, Indy. So what have you been doing last time we saw you?
It's been 4 years since my last discovery. Since then, my whole life has changed.
How so?
Now people stop me in the streets asking me for my autograph, and I didn't do anything to deserve that.
You found a lost relic and put away a known crime boss.
But I still miss the bigger fish.
That's what you focus on? You're a hero in the eyes of so many kids today.
Not in this kid's eyes. I'm just a normal guy.
A normal guy who served his country.
How did you know about my service?
I did some historical digging. Wikipedia. Folks, you see, Indy's not just a world-renowned explorer. He's a war hero from the War of 1924.
I was just a trooper taking orders.
Orders that saved thousands of lives.
I guess.
Well, that's all the time we have for today.
Oi, boss.
Thank you for talking to us, Indy.
Hello, freaks. I hate you so much. I know that you know that I hate Indiana Jones Jr. even more. So you two are gonna break in and steal the gold guitar from me. Do you understand?
Okay, boss.
All right, get going!
It's been 4 years since my last discovery. There's barely anything to show for it. If you find one impossible thing, then you can find another one. Right? Wrong. I just thought it would be a lot easier. I've searched map after map, record after record, and there's still barely anything to show for. The only thing that I know is that the Golden Rock is one of three golden objects. And how does that even help? I don't even know where to start. I thought I was done with that reporter. From Dear Indy,
I write this letter to you after much deliberation. I feel as though what has been given to me was never mine in the first place. That is why I have decided to return to you what I believe is rightfully yours. I hope you will accept my gift. Thank you for all your help, Indy. Sincerely yours.
That could only mean... the golden guitar. How did you set here for
God save the Queen, there's nothing here. Shine a light over here. Now then, check over here.
I need to go. There's someone in my shed!
Blimey! Nothing over here! Wait! Someone's coming! Hide!
Hey, you kids! Get off my property! I've warned you before and I'm warning you again!
Oi! Got it!
Oh, it's just a rat. I guess I was just hearing stuff. I'm gonna go to bed.
That was a close one. Once he falls asleep, or break into his house and steal the map. Got it?
It's fun. My favorite one syllable word.
bus. We got a map.
Good. Good. The plan is all coming together now. Go and translate it.
It's in English.
Just do it.
Okay. Somebody broke my house? Huh? I got a guitar. It's still here. They cut the strings off? What? This is just useless. What am I supposed to do without the map to the Golden Rock, or else I can't do anything? What is that? There's a map inside of it. The ink must have bled into the gold over the years. This map matches it. I got a map! I got a map! Wyoming. I don't even know why I told you that.
Oh, sure, hon. Here you go. Anything else with that?
Oh, I'm looking for the Wyoming, nature preserve.
Oh, yeah, of course, the nature preserve. All right, so, this is Wyoming here. Mm-hmm. This is where the coffee shop is. All right, and then over here is the nature preserve. All right, you got that? It's all the way over here.
Okay.
All right, got that?
Got
that. All right.
Oh, could I have some sugar? Ma'am, where did she go? What do I do?
What is it? The bridge!
I found it, the golden rock.
Oh no, this cave's gonna collapse. I gotta get out of here.
Elmo!
Surprised?
Since you're the only villain in my line of work, I'm not really surprised.
But that ruins the moment. No need for an evil monologue, I guess.
Please don't do one. Last time you did that, remember?
Too bad. I'm doing one anyway. Anyways, I was born at a young age. My twin brother and I were born on the back alleys of Sesame Street, and they were rough. And they didn't treat you like the day was sponsored by the letter P, or that Frank Sinatra was gonna sing the alphabet with you. No, we had to fight for life. Eventually, my twin brother was offered a lead role on a documentary series titled Sesame Street, off the streets we were living on. He took my name and my life for that silly show about learning. So I swore that I would have my revenge. I slowly built my empire, tricking grandmothers into telling me their social security numbers, calling people about their cars' extended warranties, and getting small jobs from people like the professor who wanted the golden guitar. I climbed my way to the top, hiring others like me who just wanted a chance at life. So after I was asked to go after the golden guitar, I did some research and found out there was the other golden artifacts, such as the golden rock.
What? Why would you want a golden rock now when everything seems to be coming together for you?
Don't interrupt my villain speech. If you didn't know, when covered in maple syrup, the golden rock has the power to control others. I would finally be able to get back at my sorry excuse for a brother. I will retake my rightful place as star of Sesame Street. The segmented title Elmo's World will no longer be a segment where a furball absentmindedly talks to a goldfish. No, now there will be monster truck rallies, and the song Hey Sir Sister will be on loop at all times.
Really? That song?
Don't judge that song. It kept me out of some dark places. So to conclude, give me the treasure.
I would give it to you. I mean, I wouldn't give it to you if I had it, but I don't have it.
Aww, you don't have it.
I can literally see it in your hand. Give it to me now, or my friend over there is gonna kill you.
You think I didn't see this coming? I beg to differ. I'm leaving this place with the golden rock and you two as prisoners.
Oh, really? You're next.